Hi, this is Aziz Kapadia from Sharp Programmer. In this video, we will learn how to authenticate .NET Framework MVC web app and call secure API app. It will cover below topics. Register an API app in Azure Active Directory. Expose API scopes. Register .NET Framework client app in Azure Active Directory. Configure client app permissions. Configure client app web project in Visual Studio. Run API and web client apps locally. Download the solution from GitHub. GitHub repository link is in the description. After cloning or unzipping files, navigate to SRC folder and open solution in Visual Studio. We will fill in these setting values in app settings file after registering API app in Azure Active Directory. First, we will register catalog API with Azure AD. Log in to Azure portal and open Azure Active Directory page. Click on app registration blade. Click on plus new registration link. Enter gherkin.catalog.api in name text box. Select this option for supported account types, which allows users from multiple tenants. Leave the redirect URI blank and click on register button. Now click on expose an API link in the application menu blade. Click on Add a Scope link. Azure opens a panel at the right hand side. It displays an ID URI, something like API:// followed by an unique identifier. We can use this as it is, or we can define our own URI. But this URI should be unique. Leave it as it is and click on Save and Continue button. Enter products.view.all in the scope name text box. Select admin and users for who can consent. Enter view all products in admin consent display name and user consent display name text boxes. Enter allows the app to get all products in admin consent description and user consent description text boxes. Leave state enabled and click on Add Scope button. A scope will be added in the list. Open appsettings.json file of gherkin.catalog.api project. Open gherkin.catalog.api app registration overview blade. Copy application/client ID value and paste in the app setting files client ID setting value. Copy tenant ID value and paste in the app setting files tenant ID setting value. Now we will register the web app which will connect to this API securely. Switch to Azure portal and open Azure Active Directory app registration blade. Click on plus new registration in property information blade command bar. Enter gherkin.catalog.webclient.net framework in the name text box. Select same third option for the supported account types. Enter https://localhost:443.26/ in the redirect URIs text box. Click on register button at the bottom of the page. Once registration is done, go to authenticate property blade. Select ID tokens checkbox and click on save button at the top. Now go to API permissions property blade and click on plus add a permission link. Azure opens a new panel at the right hand side of the screen. Select my APIs tab and then select gherkin.catalog.api app from the list. select Delegated Permission. Azure displays all the delegated permissions. Here it is only one. Select Products.View.All checkbox and click on Add Permissions button at the bottom. Once permission is added, then go to Certificates and Secrets property blade. Click on plus New Client Secret button. Leave description blank and expires in 1 year selected and click on Add button. Copy the newly added secret and store it somewhere safe. It will not be visible once we leave the App Registration blade. Go to Overview blade and copy Application or Client ID. Switch to Visual Studio Solution. Open gherkin.catalog.webclient.net framework apps web.config file and paste this Client ID in Client ID setting value. Also fill in Tenant ID and Secret. Save and close the config file. Make sure gherkin.catalog.api project is set up as startup project. Run the project using this Run button or press F5 key on the keyboard. Once it is running, then in the Visual Studio solution, right click on gherkin.catalog.webclient.net framework project and select Debug. Select Start New Instance from the menu. Once this project is also running, then click on Sign In Using Microsoft. Enter username and password. If you have MFA enabled, then you might need to complete another verification step. Once logged in, then click on View Products link. You should get the products from the Products API endpoint. We can debug the project same way we did in .NET Core project. Let's debug the client app. I have set up the debug points here in Products controller. When user hits the View Products link, then the Products controller method is invoked. It builds the confidential client app and then gets the accounts. It then tries to acquire tokens silently from cache and checks for the scopes. Then it calls to Catalog API to get products. And it gets the product since token contains correct scope. I hope this tutorial would help you to correctly configure the .NET framework project for Azure AD Authentication and call Secure API. Please leave your comments and suggestions below. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon to get notified for the new videos.